Father, we come to give you thank you. Thank you, God, for your spirit that is in this place. God, we know that the ground has been tilled, broken up, God, so that we can plant a seed. Father, as we come, that we open up our ears and our hearts so that the seed of the Word of God, which is the Word of God, can be planted. We thank you. We bless you. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 We remain standing in the Word of God. It's coming from 2 Chronicles 7. We're still dealing. And this is a crucial time. And in a crucial time where man would get in his truck and run over people while they're standing celebrating. I touch your neighbor, God is still in charge. He's in charge. Look at the 7th chapter, start with verse 15. He said, "Now my ears or my eyes shall be open, and my ears attentive to the prayer that is in this place. For now I have chosen and sanctified," say sanctified.
Sanctified.
This house. "That my name shall be there, and my eye and my heart shall be there perpetually. And as for thee, if thou walk before me as thy father, David thy father walked, and do all according to them that I have commanded thee, and thou shall observe my statutes and my judgment, then I will establish the throne of thy kingdom according to thy house. I have covenanted with David thy father, saying, thou shalt not fail thee a man to be ruler in Israel." Can I just stop right there? The result of turning back to God. What God will do when we turn back. You know, last week we talked about is my people, which are called by my name.
All right.
Shall humble themselves, pray and seek my face, turn from their wicked ways. He said, "Then what I hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins and heal the land." We talked about that on last week. Uh-huh. How God is looking for us or wants us to turn back. But what happens when we do?
Yeah, all right.
Anybody follow me? We constantly talk about change in our lives. Mm-hmm. We constantly talk about personal change. We constantly talk about blessings and how we want God to bless us. There been around people, you know, we want God to bless all the time, but we don't want to turn.
All right.
I'm talking about real blessings, because there's some phony blessings that the enemy, you know, the enemy sends us blessings, we think.
Yeah, all right.
But God says that when you turn, it is something going to happen, and it comes from me.
Uh-huh.
If you're tired of things going the same way, God here are waiting. Waiting on you to move. And when you move, he said, I'm like a chess game. When you move, then I make a move.
Uh-huh. All right.
God said, I get that. He said, but God, I cannot lie. Whenever I want a real change, whenever I want a real change in my life, I didn't ask for it, did I?
Uh-huh.
I didn't go to the revival and have the preacher to lay the hands on me.
All right.
To my when I wanted real change. When I wanted real change, all I did was the Lord.
All right.
Lord, it's me. Amen. And I got down on my knees. And I gave up, I did my hand like this because folk can lay hands on you, you're still in the same mess.
All right now, all right.
Until you, somebody help me up in here. Until you get ready to surrender yourself to Jesus.
Amen.
You in the right house.
I have a gambling problem.
All right.
I went everywhere. Until I got tired of being broke.
All right.
Yeah.
Until I got tired of begging folk for money.
All right. I know.
Lose my whole check at the track.
All right.
My Lord.
Just got paid cash. Am I talking to any real folks up in here?
Amen.
Lose my entire check.
My Lord.
And stand around while other folks win.
All right.
Hoping that they'll give me a $2 bet. And they give when they won, they gave me $10. I was so bad, knowing I didn't have no gas in my car, and still they used the $10 to put gas. I turn around and bet that.
My Lord.
He's saying, I'm waiting for you to make a move. Then I will show you what's going to happen. Wait on the church right now.
Amen. Yeah.
God say you may be the fool of us, but you sure can't fool me. Now, I'm talking to everybody. Say, see, I want to help you. I want to bless you. I want to be healed for real. I want to be delivered for real. Yes, I can open up the altar. And I can get my all out. And I can lay hands on everybody in here. But until you ready.
All right. Yeah.
Your face or your head just got greasy.
Yeah, okay. Y'all work.
Yeah. Y'all want the truth in the house? It just got greasy. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
But when you get ready.
Yeah.
You don't care if you don't have a preacher around. Come on. You don't need a preacher around when you get ready. You don't need nobody to lay hands on you when you get ready. Can I get a witness? And God is saying that that's the result that I want to show you when you do return. Good God, man. Israel, in the text, would every time God delivered them, they turn and go backwards. Every time they ask for a king, God sent them a king.
He sent them one.
He sent them some good kings,
uh-huh.
And he sent them some bad kings. Every time they get into something, they get into something, they start crying. Oh, you ever know some people like that? Oh, Lord, have mercy, Jesus.
All of that.
I don't know what I'm going to do, God, so I'm going to bring you out.
Yeah, yeah.
Look, like sometimes he brings you out just to see what it is. Now, can I just get somebody to testify and be real with me? That he'll brought you out. You said you weren't going to do that no more. And then you turn around and did that and some more. Maybe I'm by myself. See, I can testify. See, those are things that you can testify on, Sister Keith. That when you know that you've been brought out, when you know that you've been healed, if you were a rhino and you've been healed from, delivered from being on wine, I don't care what wine you bring around me.
Yeah.
It don't matter.
Because
I'm healed and I'm delivered.
Amen.
As we keep on coming around you with that stuff, you're going to get delivered from you. Because when God heals you and delivers you, he put the anointing on your life to break yoke in somebody else's life. And we wait around to God to do so much that we need. Many times, Israel messed up. And God says, I'm ready. He said, you're backsliding, even you going out backwards.
Yeah.
And God says, I'm ready to set you back. You know who you are. You are in this place. Some of you are listening to me right now. I'm talking to you.
All right.
And I'm not afraid to talk to you. Because I love you. God says, I want you blessed. For real. God says, I want you to heal. For real. God says, I want you to deliver. For real. God said, I want you to have a breakthrough. For real. Say for real. Can I get a witness? Somebody, what in all, he blessed me with a brand new car. And you can't hardly make the payment. So run with that.
Right.
Yeah. Uh-huh. All right. Now.
He didn't bless you with no car. He ain't calling you every month. Can't hold a pre-your note, can't pay your insurance. God, blessing. That's a sinner. Little ride around the morning that you got.
All right.
Trying to keep up with somebody else.
All right now. Yeah.
Somehow y'all got to help me up here. Say for real, I'm trying to bless you for real now.
For real.
The enemy has a way of setting you up. Child, I got me. Dog came over. Somebody told me. And double. More than double. Well, what I'm making.
Yeah.
Same thing I'm doing now. Oh, Lord, fill out that case. Lord, go on, fill it out. I said, let me pray about that for you. Just because it's more money.
Uh-huh.
More hell come get.
That's right, now. That's right. That's right.
So, get what I did. I let it went on back. I said, God, I thank you for what I
have. Yeah, right. That's right.
I don't have the headaches.
All right.
God said, if you do this, look at verse number 15. If you do this, he said, my eye. Look at it. Look at verse 15. He said, my eyes will come over. What you mean? Mean that his eyes been closed? No. He said, if I start hearing what you saying to me. Because guess what? God not only hears us in the physical sense, but he hears what our heart says.
Yeah, yeah.
Can I bring up a witness? The Bible says he told Hezekiah to set his house in order.
Yeah.
The Bible says Hezekiah turned his face to the wall and he prayed and he cried. That's when God started doing something.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, we The reason why we ain't seen that we ain't done that.
All right.
We can get up and preach to our ears for a while. The reason why we ain't seen that we ain't done that. Somebody will get praise God for that. Right. He said, look, my eye, God's eyes ain't never closed.
Right.
Somebody start praying for somebody start praying for real. God said, oh, somebody pray.
Yeah.
Oh, did somebody pray? Can't wait up with you. Woman that had a problem.
Yeah.
Had an issue, blood, 12 on me.
Yeah.
She woke up and touch the hem of his garment. Jesus said, who touched me?
All right.
Are you with me? I want to make sure that when we leave this place, that we want to make sure, I want to make sure that you have a message. Jesus said, who touched me? The disciples had a whole lot of sense. They said, Master, all these people, they're standing around you. You ask me, who it is that touched you? Jesus wasn't blind. He was God. He felt that touch even before the foundation of the world. He already know.
That's right.
But he said, this touch, I felt power. Oh, God. I felt some Shekinah glory.
Yeah.
Oh, I felt some power. It came away from me. Jesus said, ooh, that touch moved. Oh God, that touch moved me.
Yeah.
Because everybody else that was standing around, they were just bumping into him.
Yeah.
See, I was, see what's wrong with y'all? Y'all just bumping into him. Some of y'all just bumping into him right now. But you ain't really touching him.
Yeah.
Because Jesus said, ain't no power left me.
Alright.
That kind of touch. God Almighty, when that kind of touch, it gets Jesus' attention.
Yeah.
Jesus looked around and said, who touched me? Well, first of all, he knew the woman's name, knew her nationality. He just wanted to hear from the woman.
That's right. Yeah.
Or am I speaking to somebody here? Quit wasting time. Here come meet week in your poor weekend on the Sunday. Meet, bit, and bark. He knows it. He knows it. Y'all might cry on me up in here. He knows it. Touch your neighbor, he knows it. Some of you here know when our children are weird, really.
Yeah,
that's
right.
I know my children, I know, boy, you lying, I tell them, boy, you lying. No, I'm not that, no, boy, I know it.
No, you got them down pat.
Mama, we know it, though.
I know.
We know it.
Yeah.
He said my eye will be open. What else he says? My what? Come on. I want to make sure I get this. He said now, after what now means that after this has happened. Not before. He says, oh, somebody's going to be blessed when you leave today. Touch and you're going to be blessed when you leave today.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're gonna be blessed. He said, for my eyes shall be open and my ears attend to the prayer that is made in this place. Is he hard of hearing?
No.
Oh no.
Can I just find you one scripture to bag up what I'm talking about? Turn to Isaiah. Come on. Isaiah, come on.
I think that's 61. Make sure. Yeah. Find in a minute. I just wanted you to hear and see for yourself. But I found it. He says, my eyes are not, and my ears are not closed that I cannot hear. He said, but your sins and your iniquity has separated you from me. Touch your neighbor, I didn't pick a good day to come. But then tell him again, it's really good for me. This is good to you. God said, my eyes is not shut. They ain't closed. He said, but you got the stuff that you doing is blocking me.
Right. Yeah.
I finally can give it to you later, but it's blocking me. I can't hear what you're telling me. In other words, the prayers that you're praying is not even making it to the ceiling. All right.
My Lord.
Anybody ever pray the prayer, you know I'm going to well. Maybe I'm the only one in the room having them pray the prayer knowing I was wrong. Knowing I wouldn't finish God. You know what the prayer I pray? Let me tell you the prayer I pray. I said, Lord, forgive me, but I'm gonna do this anyway.
My Lord.
Yeah, when you ask God to forgive you before you do it.
Yeah.
Anybody ever did that? Yeah. I asked God to forgive me before I did it. And I went on and did it anyway, knew it was wrong. Do you think God heard that? He didn't hear. You know what I did? First of all, I belong to him. But I wanted to do something that I knew was wrong. But I was going to do it anyway, no matter what God said about it. Come on, somebody. Maybe I'm talking to some Holy Ghost sanctified, never done that before in their life. God, I said he had mercy upon me. Because he should have struck me down when I said it.
Right.
And yeah, that's right.
Then another thing is, Lord, if you bring me out of this
Lord.
Yeah. I'll come to do GF, sir. I'll try to make it a Bible study. I'll start treating everybody. Lord, I ain't gonna tell another lie. Here. Anybody ever done that?
Yeah.
God says, you really want to open my eyes.
Yeah.
He says, then I set up camp in this town. Oh, I set up camp, Sister Gilly, in this place. When you do that, I set up a place of inhabitants. Because the Bible says he inhabits the praise of his people. When you really start praying and turning for real. God says, I holler out a place. And I place my name there. We can start up a church in a second.
Yeah.
And give it a name, we go.
Right.
Yeah.
Don't mean God in there.
Right.
All right.
Now. Am I blessing? See, if I don't tell you the truth, then you ain't got nothing to go with. That's it. Even if you go back when you leave this place, you go back and you do the same thing, I'm gonna still tell you.
All right.
Because what happened is, here's what I want to do. Come on, spot. Here's what I want to happen. Is when you start to do it the next time, the Holy Ghost will nudge you in the side and say, uh-uh. He said, I want to set up camp. In this place. Say in this place.
In this place.
This is the place. Now, back then, Sister Woods, he was talking about the tabernacle. He was talking about the tabernacle. Well, this is building. It's not where he wants to set up camp.
Right.
I'm going to a close over here now.
Amen.
This building, somebody, is not where he wants to set up camp.
Amen.
He wants to set up camp in your heart.
All right.
Romans 12:1, I beseech you, my brother, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice. Holy and acceptable to God, which is your reason to serve. 1 Corinthians 3 talks about that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, where God dwells in it, and said you are not yourself. You are, matter of fact, you don't own yourself.
Right.
You've been bought with Christ.
Amen.
Can I get a win? Somebody help me. See, we like to shout off a car.
All right.
I like to shout off being delivered. A car, hey man, God will give you a car. Allow you to get the car and break down before you get to the house.
All
right. That ain't that. Hey man, I don't pray for cars.
Amen.
Y'all mighty quiet when I say that.
Yeah,
I don't pray for a house. I don't pray for food. Oh, Pastor just lost them.
My Lord.
Did I lose anybody?
No.
Huh? Philippians 4:19 said, but my God shall supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Matthew 6:8 said, he already know what you need even before you ask. All we got to do, come on, is stay in him. If you stay in him, that becomes his problem. Yeah, amen. If I'm in him, amen, if I need a car to go to work, God can provide that car to go to work. That's what I'm going to have to pray for. If I'm in him, amen, God can provide me a house to live in if I'm doing his will. Come on, amen, amen. If I'm in his will, amen, amen, he'll make a rain. Come on, amen. Bring me food in the morning and bring me food in the evening. He'll make a rain and come and save me when I'm his child. This is the temple. Everything I'm gonna go in here.
All right. Yeah. Right. All right now.
Amen.
All kinds of stuff going in.
My Lord.
I'm not gonna name, but if you get me upset, I'll name everything. Everything. Don't you want to go in this temple?
All right.
I was just talking, and then I'm closing. I'm just talking. Somebody was just saying something. I said, they can do the heart transplant. They can do all kinds of transplants, but I ain't never seen them take a head off one body and put on another. You got to take care of your own body. Because something happened to you.
That's it.
You can't get mine. You know when people die, they donate their organs. Yeah. You never see nobody donate a head.
Right.
That indicate, boy, there'd be some young folk down. Mm-hmm. The old folk be killing for that body. Mama said, he ain't gonna act right. Give me that money. Ain't you glad God didn't set it up that way?
Oh, man.
Amen. He says, I want to set up camp. I want you to get this today. I want to set up camp in this house. New generation. This is going to be a place. You know they said that the Spirit of God dwells. God don't dwell in no unclean place.
All
right. And the only way that the Spirit of God can dwell, that we start forgiving one another.
Yeah.
That we start loving each other.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Sometimes we act like we never did nothing in our life. God said, I want to set up a residence in this place.
Yeah.
God said, I want my name to be hollered out in this place.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. God says, when you deliver for real, he said, I want to come in and set up camp. I'm going to open my eyes.
Yeah.
God said, I know I've seen you prayed over and over again. I've seen some deacons come down here and pray.
Yeah.
But this one time I saw a deacon pray. I said, Lord, you heard that one.
Right now.
But then again, I heard and saw some prayer. I said, Lord, I know you didn't hear that one.
All right.
Pastors as well. God says, I want you to pray so that my eyes are going to be open.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wake up, God. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Wake up, God. I don't know. And I know he ain't asleep, but sometimes we need to wake him up.
Yeah, yeah.
Wake him up and say, God, he'll hear my...
Yeah.
Not my mother, not my father.
Yeah.
But it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer.
Yeah.
God, I don't know about anybody else. What's wrong with us too much today? We talk about other folk. We holler about other folks' sin. But we never concerned about your own sin. Can I get a witness? There was a man that was preaching a sermon called Watch Them Dog. There was this old hound dog. Meat was on the stove. Saw the meat was very hot. He went up and grabbed the meat. He was hollering every step of the way. But he wouldn't drop the meat. Come on, somebody. If your sins are bothering you, you holler about your sin, you are the wrong brother. Can I get a witness? And when I tell the Lord, Lord, I can't talk about nobody else. I just want to talk about old Joe Webb. Because Joe Webb got some things in his mind. Can I get a witness? That God, you ain't finished with me yet. I'm trying to get better and better. If you're in the room today, yes, I know you see this robe that I got on. It's all white and pretty. But there's some issues that I have to deal with every day of my life. Can I get a witness? Touch a neighbor. The neighbor down to Joel need Jesus. a cuss word will slip out from your mouth and mine too. And see, that's why I'm not ashamed to let everybody know that I need him. Can I get a witness? Because when God, when I start praying, I want God's eyes to be open. Can I get a witness? And I don't know about you, but anybody feel like I do? I know I'm just a little long today, but anybody feel like I do? I want God to open his eyes and hear and see when I'm praying. I want God to open his ears to hear me when I get up and pray. Can I get a witness? If you're honest with yourself, the Bible said, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Can I get a witness? If you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive your sin and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. Can I get a witness? Even Paul, the apostle Paul, the one that wrote all the books, the one that could heal, the one that could raise up the dead, but he picked it up in Romans 7, for me to will. Paul says, I want to do right, but sometimes my mind is not there. When I will to do right, evil is always present. Sometimes I do wrong, but I want to do right, because I think evil things touch the name of the old wretched man that I am. Who shall deliver me from this body, from this sin and death?
God says he wants to open up your eyes.
every day. Anybody that says you're a better person, like, are you a better person? Are you a better person? But if you like I am, raise your hand and just say, well, Lord, I got to a place and I know I need to go further. He's not fed with us. God says, I want to dwell in your house. I want to dwell in your place. You'd be going, but you'd be the one that says, Lord God, I have not accepted you as my Lord and Savior. Will you come? Secondly, if you're here and you've been out of the ark of safety for a long time and want to dedicate your life back to Jesus Christ, you can come. Third, if you're here, well, Pastor, I'm here and I felt that the Spirit of God has led me to be a part of what God is doing here at New Generation Church. If you're here and want to be a part of what God is doing here at New Generation, you come. By that word, I know I was. While they're coming, again, let's give our children a hand. We'll be ready to take them to Peace of Hut, so want to donate while you're leaving out the door. Get with Brother George Gator and just give something to him. If you just want to donate, we get ready to take our kids to Peace of Heaven. So get ready.
Amen.
That's why he came to cover us for our sins. And all we got to do is ask God for forgiveness. If you have not been baptized, you don't need to be taken in as well. Have not. But if you take it in an unworthy manner, the Bible says some people got sick. If I'm in Bible country, maybe some people got sick and even died. We remember, look at the cross. That's why we got it lit up. We remember what he did for us on the cross. And notice with the word like today, if you don't leave out here better, it's your own fault. What I mean by leaving out here better, your problem is going to be there, but your attitude will be different. Your spirit will be different. God said, I'm looking for a place that I can dwell. This is a better place. He's dwelling in my temple.